Hi, friends. I'm Legia here at New York City Comic Con. I'm here with the amazing Gisele Lagace, and you're with ComicsVerse. Exorsisters is your newest comic coming out. It drops October 17th. How did this project come into being?
I was looking to collaborate with someone new, and my friend Nick Bradshaw says maybe you should work with Ian Boothby, and because he knew that I like to work on stuff that has a bit of humor in there. So we talked to, I approached him, and then it's went from there. He pitched some projects to me, what would be interesting for me, and this was the one that I gravitated towards too. So, and you know, from there on, of course, you know, I've put my own touch to it as well, and that's so, you know, took a couple of months to put this together, but it's going well.
It was awesome. I was actually wondering how you met Ian Boothby, so this is really interesting.
Yeah, it's actually just through Nick Bradshaw, but I mean, you know, I was familiar with his work too, because he worked with, you know, on The Simpsons, Futurama, stuff like that, and you know, he also has a new series coming out through Scholastics, Sparks, which is also very fun. So I think it was a good match. So I'm glad that, you know, that Nick, you know, suggested him. So,
yeah, no, that's awesome. Now, Cate and Cate Harrow are a pair of sisters who are, their style is interestingly very goth punk, which is really different from like JEM and the Holograms that you've worked on and the Archie comics. So where did the idea for that kind of style, other than like their overall style, come from, you know?
I think it's probably just me. It's probably closer to who I am in a way, you know? I mean, it represents, you know, two people, but one is really sort of like more punk, which was me when I was much younger, you know? Not that now, but, you know, I think, and I also like music, so I tried to show that she has a lot of taste in music, the Cate with a K. And the other one's a little bit more serious. I guess, you know, it shows two personalities that are contrasting, you know? But I think that's what's going to make it fun, so.
Yeah, no, I love their dualities. I actually have a sister, and we're kind of similar in that way, where one's, like, a little over the top, and the other one's much more serious.
Yeah.
You mentioned that you have a lot of anime influences. Specifically, you mentioned Rumiko Takahashi and Takeshi Obata. So how do you feel that their influences feed into your work?
A lot, especially Rumiko Takahashi. She has I've followed her work since the very beginning. You know, like Yurusei Yatsura, Rama One Half, Inuyasha, Maison et Cuckoo, I could go on. But like for me, even her most recent series called Renee, it's very similar to that, because, you know, the they're trying to help people go to, you know, the other side, the exorcism and stuff like that. So there is something to it that to me is very similar to what we're doing with Exorsisters, and even Inuyasha in a way as well, with all the creatures, the demons and stuff like that, same thing there. And for the Bata, well, Death Note, there's a lot of demons and, you know, the whole aspect of heaven and hell, and it's pretty much that. I mean, I like his style. He's more realistic than Rumiko Takahashi, but he still has a bit of a cartoony style when he does stuff like the Bakuman and stuff like that. So I'm a big fan of manga. So.
It's like, manga's great. I also grew up with Ranma One Half, and I'm just like, it's so fun.
I love Ranma. Very good.
Oh, yeah. So the other thing I was wondering is, I know that the Archie comics and JEM and the Holograms are pretty different from what the Exorcisters are. I know that one is a little bit more franchised than the Exorcisters, and I was wondering, do you have a preference on if you'd like working with franchised work more, or if you like this independently, run comics?
Oh, no question. I prefer to work on my own stuff. I mean, 100% at a time. I don't mind franchises. Like JEM was fine because, I mean, it was, I used to be in a girl band. So for me, it was sort of similar. When I did the Archie stuff, it was Archie Meets the Ramones. And so to me, there was a connection. I was sort of a punk. So for me, I like the Ramones. And I also, you know, I wanted to work on Josie and the Pussycat, which was also like a band thing, which, so I got to do that a little bit with JEM in a way. So, I mean, I'm a little bit too old to have grown up with JEM, but I mean, I'm still very familiar with it. I mean, I was still sort of like a teenager when that came out, and I mean, I watched it and everything. So I do have an affinity. I do like it. It's just that when you're doing your own stuff, it just, I don't know, it just feels better. I'm more motivated and stuff like that. So.
No, definitely. What did you play in your band?
Actually, I could play almost any instrument, but I chose the bass simply because I was a big fan of Gene Simmons when I was a little kid. I don't know why I was fascinated with his demon face and everything like that. So I guess there's something with hell for me. Anyway, so yeah, I to me it fit my personality more. So, but I could play guitar and stuff like that. But the bass just it fit me. You know, it was me. So.
I love the bass. I play a little bit of bass too, so this is really cool. Now, are there any other upcoming projects that you're working on other than Exorsisters that you want to mention and have readers kind of keep track of?
Well, you know, for adults, although Exorsisters is considered teen plus, I do Ménage à Trois, which is a series I've been working on for years, but it's about to end. It's ending like in about 2 months. And it'll be 10 volumes total for me that I had done on that. So I've been working on it for almost 10 years. So I'm trying to complete that. And after that, I don't know what I'm going to do in regards to like more webcomics. But I plan to do Exorsisters for quite a while. So hopefully, you know, usually I always have like two projects on the go. I'm just not sure what will be the second one yet, you know.
Say a good surprise is always fun. Well, thank you so much for your time and for all the really awesome stuff. I can't wait to see Exorcisters and everything come out.
Hope everybody checks it out.
Yes! And thank you for watching. For more comic book interviews and news, visit ComicsVerse.com.